Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to our celebration of the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today's readings can be found in the Sunday Missal, page 508, Return Psalms, book of page 995. Special members at this Mass are requested for people of most blessed sacrament. Please stand and join singing your entrance in Ordinary Psalm, number 585.
Thank you.
prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication. With divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, and the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert, and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools, and the thirsty grounds springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. countenance. The people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hands on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spitting touched his tongue. And he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, be open. And immediately the man's ears were opened and his speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell it. The more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Synagogue, taking the scroll of the prophet Isaiah, reading it and proclaiming, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." Well, as we heard from the prophet Isaiah in the first reading, that the Lord would come to his faithful ones to save them. The Lord of vindication comes with divine recompense, who would make those who are blind see, those who are deaf to hear, those who cannot walk to be able to leap like a stepping. Streams would burst forth with water in the desert. As we think of our Lord today, fulfilling in a very literal sense this prophecy of Isaiah, we know that like Isaiah's prophecy pointed beyond just the physical healing and salvation that would come, but salvation that would come to God's faithful goes beyond those things we know of our Lord. He is the salvation of his people. In this life and the next, he comes to give a life beyond what was capable of humanity or what we were capable before. The ability to hear and what we see goes beyond what we would have had before with just normal physical sight and normal hearing. Lord reveals himself in this way. So as we look not just to the historical healing as beautiful and as powerful as that is in the Gospels, we can learn from the way our Lord inflames and reinvigorates these senses, bringing them from even a dead state back to life and giving them something completely new. Because our Lord gives in his way a full measure, an ability to hear him, to see him. And so we explore then the ways that our senses can be attuned in a new way to this way our Lord wants to nourish us. We think of three ways that we look up to God, we look at ourselves, and then the rest of the world, having our sight restored, our ability to hear renewed. We think of our Lord and his voice saying, "Be thou open," would have been the first thing this man had ever heard. He was deaf. He was unable to speak because of that. And immediately upon our Lord's embracing this man, his ability to hear returns. We think also when he heals people who are blind, how they would open their eyes and the very first thing they see is Jesus. You would ever think, if you had never seen anything before, and you had never heard any voice before that, you will always compare every single thing you see back to that first vision of God, the healing, loving Savior, and his powerful word that brings a restoration of health. You would never forget. And our Lord has come to open our eyes with the gift of faith to remind ourselves each day who he is and then the glory that he has by his own nature in heaven and then coming to earth. How much love he has, our omnipotent creator, for his simple creatures. He desires us to live in abundance, having the restoration not only of an earthly son, but the illumination that comes from the ability to see and know God is. Having looked at our God with those eyes of faith, we can look at ourselves, hopefully, in a different light as well. Take the time to look at yourself in the mirror as I do to thank God that there's more than what meets the eye that's there. I think that my doctor said your body is a work of art. And I had said that, and he said, no, Father, I said you're a piece of work. But whatever it is, we know that there's not just what apparent to the eyes that are there because of the Lord and how he's looked upon us. We can look in there, and while knowing the imperfections that are certainly there, and how each sin doesn't just offend the God we love, but also is a failure to live up to that potential, not because of simply what we see, but because we can see God looking at us, who has given us an ability to bear his image, and because we look at our Creator's face, we know what that image should look like. It'll be a lifelong endeavor to try to live up to that sacred vision. But nonetheless, it's always there. Whether we have sinned, maybe gravely, and separated ourselves from him, the words to be open and come back to life again are spoken by our Lord, who wants us to live. He's searching us out and wants us to see ourselves in that same way. Having looked upon God, and hopefully then at ourselves and finding that same divine image in the way of ourselves, we view the rest of the world. Not just the world in a general way, but every person who has the same divine image ascribed to them by having the same one Creator. We recognize that that too is a lifelong challenge. Kind of where we react to the news of the day, the challenges of the people around us, maybe those who give particular challenge, and trying to run through these three types of sensory vision and applying our faith to it, to remember the God who made us, the one who has redeemed us in our own need to stand before him for help, and of course, that same destiny given to all. Hopefully then, we'll hit the second part because our Lord doesn't simply restore man's ability to take in words, sound. He opens his mouth to speak. So our senses of faith have been given not just for our sanctification, but for the benefit of all. But we speak the same word of Jesus in his holy name to a world that needs to hear it so desperately. We know that as Christians, that in short, we see and view the world different than those who do not know Christ in the way that we do. But in turn, by recognizing that, we should have that desire to speak. There's so many ways that we can show his face, make his words perfect on a daily basis in our real lives, and that we don't stand on our own path. This is something God has given within us, brings it out of us, the goodness in our daily lives, to be able to bring the good news to those who need it. Salvation comes to his people. The Lord, as he promises in Isaiah's prophecy, will be made known to everyone. One day every eye shall see, every ear will hear his voice and know that he is God. It's part of our mission to make sure as many as possible come to know that before the final event, when they meet God at the end of their lives or at the end of time, when everything appears before them. To see a God filled with love, one who has filled us with the measure even of his own divine glory, that we have been given an ear to hear, eye to see, and a mouth speak his word. Mm-hmm. by your deep and wide God.
Father, the giver of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible, by the name of one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and justified, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism with the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us bring our prayers before the Lord, who desires to give us what we truly need.
For Pope Francis and all bishops, may God bless them with unity and fortitude. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in Afghanistan and around the world affected by violence and instability, may God bless and console them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who need physical, emotional, or spiritual healing, may God extend his hand to them and make them well. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For relief agencies, religious organizations, first responders, and emergency crews, as they tend to the needs of all affected by Hurricane Ida, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may God welcome them into his eternal peace, and for people of Most Blessed Sacrament Parish, who remember in this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Also lift up in prayer all of our military personnel that they be kept safe, and for all veterans, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for this Labor Day weekend, for all those who go without employment and who seek it, that they may find it, and for God to bless and reward the labors that we do and bring them to completion and dignity. Let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, thank you for hearing our prayers. We ask that you answer them according to your holy will, Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us join in singing from the Journey Songbook, number 615, The Fruits of His Creation.
Thank you.
due fitting homage to the work of God majesty, that by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, we give
you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give it to us, O Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with the angels we praise you as a joyful celebration we unveil.
Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son,
filled with his Holy Spirit, may become the body of the Spirit of Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that you may obtain an inheritance in glory now, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs, and the all the saints, on whose consecrated possession in your presence, we rely on our failing God. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation be prayed for, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm the faith and charity of the local church on earth, with your servant Francis on Pope and Alfred on Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who are gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. You are departed, brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this time, give kindly thanks to your people. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world with all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Here I am.
remain seated for just a moment. Two announcements to make. One I'm happy to make here is a reminder that 7 o'clock Thursday night is our choir meet and greet. So anybody who would like to join the choir for the very first time, or members that have been members of the choir for over the years, first meeting in a long time, will be a nice meet and greet, and also with some food on Thursday night in Schneider Hall. So we're getting the band back together tonight. Over the weeks and months of being here, I've heard a lot of great voices, not just the cantors who do such a beautiful job for us, but also out in the pews. So this is something that is so important, because next to what I'm doing as a priest and the servers, it's singing the Mass, it's bringing to life the sacred liturgy, and it's such an important ministry. So if you have that talent from God to be able to sing, you can please share that back with them. There's the other priests only. If you don't have the talent, you can always get even with them and join the choir. But it's a wonderful way to praise our Lord as a service here in our parish. Secondly, you'll be hearing weekly transmissions from now until the Oktoberfest. So some things to know. I'm happy to go through the menu. You know that. I'm very happy to talk about food. And so some of the things that we're going to be having, of course, rockers and pretzels, we'll have hot dogs, we will have pork sandwiches, we'll have pierogi, we'll have German potato salad, sauerkraut and braised cabbage, valley burgers and french fries, and I think I got most of it, pretty close. Of course, I'll be there with the funnel cakes, you know, my favorite spot, and happy just looking forward to it. On that food, we have, I think, 5 or 6 different kinds of beers as well, so I'm happy to say we'll have the, I always get this wrong, is it Eddie something, somebody help me, Eddie something orchestra. Eddie.
I don't remember, Father.
Nobody knows? We'll add that out of the video. Whenever, we have a polka band coming that's pretty well known, or looking forward to that, getting moving around a little bit as well. So a lot of things coming together, and it'll be quite a beautiful experience for our parish. So there's different ways to support. Please sign up to help. So many of you have already, so thank you for that. Still some more help that we can use. We need those who are good bakers to donate some baked items to have as desserts that day as well. Sell. So if you'd like to do that ahead of time, bring it maybe the day before, we can get that set up and have those offered as well. And also, if you want to just donate to offset some of the cost of the food we'll be ordering shortly, whatever it is, it's greatly appreciated. It all goes to help the parish. And I really thank you. Looking forward to a great community building event in real time on September 12th. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful Lord, we nourish and endow with life through the fruit of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share of his life, who lives and reigns forever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We'll report the Mass of
thanks be to God.
Saint Michael,
you are our angel, the presence of God, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God be with you in your mother, we pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, the power of God, cast into hell Satan, and all the evil spirits, who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Please join us singing our recessional hymns found here in the songbook, number 682, Go to the Mountains.